Are you looking to triple your conversion rate? Imagine turning your passive visitors into engaged buyers. That's what everyone is looking for, right? In this video, I'm gonna tell you some tips and tricks via gamified pop-ups through which you can increase your leads and eventually sales on your Shopify store or your WordPress, or you are using any other platform. So you might be thinking, what is this gamified? So let me give you an example. Have you seen the spin to wheel pop-up? Or there's another type of pop-up, which is like when you scratch a card, it's gonna give you a gift. You can add these type of pop-ups on your platform like Shopify, WordPress, without needing to code. All you have to do is just follow this video and you'll be able to add it. Do you know that by adding spin to wheel pop-up, you'll be able to increase the conversion rate by 400%. And with other scratch card pop-up or any other template, it's gonna be 3x of your conversion as compared to the normal pop-ups. Now, when I talk about the spin to wheel and gamified pop-up, let me show you how it's gonna look like. So this is the platform which we'll be using, which is claspo.io, and it's really easy to use. You don't need any coding knowledge. You don't have to be a developer to use that. All you have to do is just sign up using your Google email or any other email which you have. And once you log in, you'll have a drag and drop platform to add in pop-up to your platform. And they have tons of templates. And I was showing you the gamified pop-up templates, right? So here's the template of a spin to wheel. And this is the play to win a prize. So if we click on that, we can also see the preview, right? And we will be using this platform to add pop-up to our store. And this is my Shopify store. And I'm gonna teach you how you can do that and basically turn your visitors into engaged buyers and increase your email list. So it's really good to have a huge email list through which you can send your offers, coupon codes, and eventually increase your sales. So without further ado, let's start implementing that, where I'm gonna go over this platform with you guys in this video and show you guys how easy it is to set up pop-up within claspo.io, and you don't need any coding knowledge. So guys, this is my Shopify store, and I am looking to add a spin to wheel pop-up on this store. Now, what I'm gonna do, I'll first Google Claspo. And it already showed up on my browsing history. But if you will do the Google, it's gonna show up on the top. So that's claspo.io. I've already opened that. I'm already signed up and logged in. And once you logged in, you will see something like this. And now you will need to select which type of pop-up you're looking to get. So I'm looking to grow my email list, right? So let's click on grow email list. And it's gonna give you the option to select which templates you're looking to add. So here we have spin to wheel, and there are hundreds of thousands of templates which you can use based on your theme, based on your color scheme, and you will also be able to customize these pop-ups. So if you want to change the color scheme later on after creating the pop-up, you can do that. So choose any one which you like, and based on your theme and based on your website styling and color palette, you can then later on customize that, right? So I'm gonna choose any spin to wheel one. So let's click on that one. And here, let's click on use this template. Okay, now here we have the option to customize the colors and to customize the text which we want to. So if you want to change the text, simply click on that. And here you will have the option to change the text. So I'm just going to type in anything. Enter your email and spin the wheel for a chance to win amazing prizes. Yeah, it's actually written whatever I wanted to write. So it's already written here. I'm just gonna remove some extra wording here. And as my color scheme is this one, I'm gonna try to change the color scheme to see how it looks. So let's click on that and see where we have the option to change the color scheme. Okay, so after clicking on this wheel, here we have the option to color. So I'm gonna choose a color from here. So in order to grab the color code from my website, I am going to inspect, and copy the color code from my Chrome tools. Perfect. Okay, so that's my color code in RGBA. I want in hex. So where can I find the hex code? Let's take a new one. See, where can I find the hex code? Okay, here it is. So let's click on that. So here's the hex code which I want to add. I'm just gonna copy it from here and then paste on these colors here. I'm gonna replace it with this, and here you go. Now you can see that the spin wheel is now looking similar to what I have on my theme, right? Now let's try changing the color for the heading and for this button. Click on that button, and here we have all of the styling showing up. Similarly, doing the same. So color is now showing up. So let's click on that color, and here we have the spin now button is showing up, but the text color is white, which is looking a bit weird because it's less visible. So what we're gonna do, we'll change it to black. Okay, let's change the text color to black. Looks good, but when we hover over, it's still the black color which is not making it visible. Now what we're gonna do, we will change the background color of hover to, okay, background text color. Yep, there we go. We just had to toggle this on to change the hover color of text to be white. And you can see now when I hover over it, it's looking completely fine. Now, the other thing I want to change is this color for this heading here. Click on that and let's click on the color swatch. And again, click on this color swatch here to add our colors. Perfect. Looks good. Actually, it's less visible, so I'm going to change it to black. And that's much better, I think, right? Yep, looks good. And let's see what options do we have on the background. I think that's good enough. Oops, let's change the button color as well. Change it to black, I guess, would be fine. Yep, looks much better. What else can we change here? So this is the background image which is being used. Let's use the plain white color, which will look much better. Yep, much better. And now here we have the orange color stroke, which is not matching to my theme. I'm just gonna change it to black, I guess. Yep. So here we have this color of stroke. We're gonna change it to black. And here we go. Our pop-up is now ready to be used. Now let's click on save. Perfect. Now we will going to add it on our website. It's giving you the rule based that it's going to show once per session. If someone spent 20 seconds on the page, it's gonna show up, and all of these rules which are showing up. We can also later on customize that. I'm gonna give you more details on the rule based thing. So first let's try to add this pop-up to our store and then work more on the triggering feature, that when do we need to trigger this pop-up, right? So let's click on next. Now this is where you can add integration. Now let's suppose you want to push the leads which coming through Claspo to HubSpot, or you want to push it to any other custom CRM you have. You can easily add integration, and based on the form submission, you can automatically then create a lead or contact in your CRM with this integration part. So it's really simple to have. You click on add integration and you will have all of these different apps showing up. So if you have ActiveCampaign, you have Brevo for later on email processing, you have ConstantContact, or you have HubSpot as your CRM. You can integrate clasp.io with any of the tools. and any of the tool is missing, you also have the Zapier option where you can then integrate with hundreds of apps, right? So let's click on next. Okay, guys, our pop-up is now ready to be published. So I'm going to click on publish widget. And here we have different options. I suggest you go with install JavaScript code because that's very simple to do. So click on install JavaScript code and all you have to do is just this copy code. You can also send this and to your developer. So simply copy code and developer instructions. It's going to give you the complete instructions. Now let's copy code and in our Shopify store, first we're going to go to the backend. And that's our development store backend for the Shopify. Click on online store. And whatever your current live theme is, click on these three small dots and then click on edit code. Once you do that, you will have to open this theme.liquid file. Open that. And below head, I'll be adding this code. So just add it below here and then paste the code. Perfect. After pasting the code, it's safe. And now all we have to do is just preview our store to see if our pop-up is showing up. So I'm going to click on preview, wait for 20 seconds to or scroll down to see our pop-up is showing up. Okay, guys, here you can see our pop-up is showing up. And when someone fill an email and click on spin now, that's how it's gonna work. And here you will add your own code. So you'll need to add set up a discount code. So if I go to Shopify backend, you will go to discount and create a discount code based on this coupon code. And once this is live, you can also change the settings after it is published. So let's go back to our Classpo dashboard and hear how it says, congratulations, your first widget has been published. Yes, we saw the pop-up. It's working completely fine after installing the JavaScript code. Let's close that and see what settings do we have. Here we have analytics where it's going to tell you how many views you got from desktop, from mobile, and what were the target actions which we took. So if I hit refresh, it should show the latest action which we took on our pop-up currently. Close it up. And here you can see the number of views and the target action. We just filled up the form and now it's saying that after two views, you got one form submission, one lead, which is 50% conversion. And if we click on gamification, it's going to tell you that what type of discount it gave. So the remaining 10% discount was given to us, right? And now let's check out the appearance tab. Here we have the appearance tab. Again, click on edit and change that way how the pop-up looks. You can also change the template. Now let's see the triggering part. I told you I'm gonna tell you some more details about that. So this is the rule-based trigger. If you want your pop-up to open up when someone click on any HTML widget or any button on your store or on your website, you can enable this HTML element click paste. And here you will add the element name. Now, in order to find the element, you might need to have a little bit code knowledge. In Chrome browser, you will simply click on inspect element for that specific element. And you will be able to get the element name with this code. But I'm not gonna go over the code details here because this is tutorial for non-technical people. So I'm gonna leave it as it is. I'm just going to disable that. And here we have the option of launcher click paste. So you can also add launcher. So let's enable that and click on new launcher to show you how it's gonna work. So here we have different launcher options. So it's going to show this type of sticky button type thing when you click on it and it will open up your pop-up, right? So here we have this start a chat, need help. All of these launchers are available, which you can use based on your needs and based on whatever you want. Like you want a coupon code, like this one is suitable for the type of pop-up which we created, right? So let's go back and check the rule based thing. So I'm going to click on triggering. And here, if I want to change the rule where the pop-up is showing up, I'm simply click on edit And here we have the option. If you want to show once per session, meaning if someone came into your website, the pop-up was shown and it was closed by the user, it's not going to show up again because that's once per session. Or if he visits another page of your website, it's not going to show up. And you can one time per day, you can set the setting as well. You can have it only once. And now it's telling us when do we need to open the pop-up. If you want the pop-up to be shown immediately, you can simply click on this immediately, and you can set these conditions here. So if someone spent 20 seconds on the page, someone spent 20 seconds on the website, someone read the page by 10%, visited three page, all of these conditions are to trigger your pop-up. So if I select on immediately, click on save, and if I go back to my store and hit refresh, it should display the pop-up immediately. Here we go. You can see that it's now immediately showing up the pop-up, right? We didn't have to wait 20 seconds for pop-up to display. Again, we have more triggers here. So if we go back to the widget, click on new widget, and then go back to rules, click on edit. We have annoyance safeguard, show in sequence using silent interval, how it works. So these are all of the different settings which you can add. You can have on page condition as well. You can have on location conditions, thousands of conditions which you can easily add to your pop-up and customize it based on your own needs, which is without any coding knowledge. That's the really important part, because if you will be coding this type of stuff, it's going to take you a lot of time to code and add this type of pop-up. Let's go to submits, and here we are showing up the submission form submission, and it should display the submission here, but I think it's going to take some time for our latest submission which we did. And here is the integration part. Again, I already told you guys how it's going to work. Simply click on add integration and integrate it with any of your CRM, or if you want the Zapier to be connected with, you can click on add Zapier webhook and easily integrate that. And here is the integration for the analytics. If you want to have better analytics as their own analytics, you can integrate Google Analytics as well and measure all of the action which are taken on that pop-up. So that's it for the video, guys. It's super simple to add in free pop-up on your store. You can add into your any of your website, not just the Shopify. Simply copy the JavaScript code to head part of your website and easily add these attractive looking pop-ups on your website with thousands of templates available and with a lot of customization option, lot of triggering option which you will be getting completely for free. And if you want to have more feature, you can go on to the paid tier. You can check out the pricing plan. So as you can see, free for a lifetime, where you will be getting all of these things. And if you want on top of that some more advanced feature, you can go to the paid tier. So make sure to try out classpo.io to add these gamified pop-up and increase the conversion rate. I hope you guys would like the video. Let me know in the comments below if you have any questions, or if you are facing any problem implementing that, or if you are facing any issues adding that pop-up on any of the platform. I would love to respond to your comments. Until next video, have a great day.